Assemblywoman, what do you think of this budget that you helped usher into law?
I think I'm very proud of this budget that we helped become law and that we finally agreed upon. I think that it's a budget that reflects some of our needs, you know, with the homestead rebate, obviously an increase in taxes, which nobody likes to do. But I think that we're at a point where if we want to continue some of our programs and some of our sustainable growth, that we needed to do some things that we did and that were necessary.
Do you think the budget is balanced for real? The governor questioned some of the revenues in the legislature's plan. He ultimately signed it, so he certified that the revenues are there. You think they're really there?
I think they're there. However, just like all other budgets, whether it's at the state level, even in your own household, budgets are kind of an ongoing process. They change from, I think, month to month. Some months we have great months, some months we don't have such great days. So I think that it's balanced, it's fair. But I think that just like every other piece of legislation, there's always effects to it. So whether we might need to retweak some issues the middle of the year, that's nothing that's abnormal.
You were in the room for some of the negotiations between the governor, the Senate president, and the speaker. From the outside, this was a real fight, a real political fight. What was it like in the room? What was the tone?
I think that when you say real political fight, people always like to hear that kind of stuff because it's juicy. Not that you're responsible for any of that, Michael. But I think that inside the room, to be honest with you, it was cordial. I think that in the most heated moments, everyone was still thoughtful in what they were asking and how they were asking. I think obviously towards the end of the negotiations, there was a little bit more tension, but everyone was very respectful. Everyone made sure that what their priorities were, they stated them, and I think that you saw that in the outcome. I think that everyone walked away with something that they were happy with.
The business community seems least happy with this budget. There's a hike in the corporate business tax. There's a hike on multimillionaires who earn more than $5 million. And then there's a loophole that the governor has long wanted to close. The combined reporting loophole, which looks very complicated, but is going to hit some businesses. What's your word to the business community?
Well, I think from when it comes down to the corporate business tax, one of the reasons that the legislature kind of was really pushing more that end, more so than the millionaires piece, was that it had to do with the federal windfall of money, that with the federal tax changes, corporations were receiving a large sum of money in order to bring back home, whether they were going to reinvest it, whether they were going to give employees raises, but it would be enough that we would be able to ask them for their fair share. So that was where we stood on the corporate business tax. The millionaires obviously was a part of the negotiation deal. Initially in the legislature's budget, we did not have that included. We felt that if we were hitting the corporations, that was really what we wanted to, because at the end of the day, the corporate business tax really goes into the general fund. Whereas you can say the millionaire's tax, right? It's a tax on people. So it would go towards the property relief fund. Combined reporting was more of a last minute negotiation piece. The governor's budget included that in there. We did not, because we felt if we were going to raise the corporate business tax, we didn't want to also punish them, quote unquote, on the combined reporting, which we've also seen a lot of other states shy away from that as well.
But you're going through with it.
We went through with it. I think that there's probably a few tweaks that we still maybe need to
come
back.
It had to do with profits that they make out of state or transferring money made in state to a lower tax.
Yeah, especially when they have different entities under one name. But the state of New Jersey has pretty strict laws already with regards to how you combine your earnings and your losses.
Republicans think you shouldn't have raised any taxes, that you should have cut spending. What do you say to that?
I think that we're getting to that point. I think that we've made it clear not only on the legislative side, but also obviously with our colleagues across the aisle from the Republican side, that come next year, we're gonna have to take a look at some spending. And maybe what we can do to offset some of those spendings and maybe have to take a serious look at some cuts.
But not this year.
Well, obviously this year. I think it was going to be very hard to do so with a new administration only being in for the first couple of months. I think that now that they have their feet quite wet, I would say, we should start really taking a look at some of the areas that we would want to revamp and take a look at some of the savings.
Assembly Budget Chair Eliana Pintor Marin, thanks very much for talking to us.
Thank you, Michael.